Scott Church with CategoryOneGames.com. We are going to bring you a profit or loss type of video, like you see from Derium CCG or Open Boosters, what they're doing, but we're doing it with the games that we sell. We're home to classic card games like Star Trek CCG. So we are going to break open a box of Star Trek Rules of Acquisition. Now, just a second ago, I grabbed a pen or something sharp to actually open this, and now I can't seem to find it. So we're going to pull a Deriums here, and we're going to use a screwdriver to open it. And that's what he usually uses. So let's pull this open and see what we got. Now, generally, when I go to conventions, I sell these for about $15 at conventions. You can find this for, I believe, under $10 on our website, or just around that price. Maybe it's $12. I can't remember offhand. Yeah, I've got a lot of products, so I can't remember all the different price points of everything. But here's the thing with this Star Trek set. Generally, we are not going to reach our profit mark that we need to off of it. And the reason I chose this set to open is because I don't have much inventory on Rules of Acquisition. So I figured this would be a good set to open, not only to boost my own inventory, but to make a video of, and just to kind of have fun with it. There's commons and uncommons that I need from this set to help restock inventory, so I figure this is a good way to do it. It gives us a lot of cards that are in perfect condition. With the Decipher games, you usually got a rules set, so this is a rules supplement, and it goes over the information regarding the set. So like, it'll talk about a new icon, it'll talk about revised rules if there are any, notes and clarifications, it gives you new rules are here, like Ferengi, how they attack, variable attributes, phasing and cloaking, and then it's got a set list on the back so you can see what sets you are trying to get. And Decipher used to divide it up by class, basically. So artifacts, dilemmas, equipment, events, then your personnel by what subculture they're in, so like Bajoran, Kardashian, Dominion, Federation, and so on. So this is how they divide it up. In later sets like Death Star 2, they had it, I believe, just all alphabetically. And so it was interesting for collectors. Did you sort it by alphabetical, or did you sort it by the way that Decipher gave it to you? I'd be kind of curious, how did you sort it? I know I actually sorted it by this for Star Trek. For Star Wars, I did it alphabetically. But Star Trek, I always followed Decipher's layout of it. So let's start opening packs. Now, hopefully we get some good cards in here. The top cards probably are Leda. That's a card that sells very quickly. Quark is another one. This set just generally was not that strong as far as what cards were good. So this is going to be the first 1, 2, 3, 4. So 5 cards are going to be your commons. Okay. Your rare is going to be the 6th card, and then the last 3 cards are your uncommons. So most of these rares in here are going to be under a dollar. So there's 30 packs. So, I mean, if they were a dollar each, that'd be 30 bucks. Like, if you're selling on eBay, you have to raise the price of what you sell to a dollar. Though you're going to be charged more by eBay fees. But our website, we have them for a lot less than that. So if you're ever making the choice between going to eBay or our website, you always want to go to our website. So Continuing Committee, really good card. Also the name of the Star Trek Continuing Committee. That's what they named their Players Committee after. So let's keep going here. And I don't know if we'll actually make back value on this. I somehow doubt it. Grand Nagus Zek. And you can see what classifications he had for his card. The nice thing always about Decipher packs, they're easy to open. Let's see here, 4th card from the back. Oh, another Continuing Committee. Now this is pretty terrible that this is simply, we've opened 4 packs and we've gotten 2 of the same rare. Now this is terrible distribution for a game, you know, for a company that should have had better quality control than that. You should never get 2 of the same rare in the same box, especially out of only 30 packs. The rare sheet should just never double like that. Lamech is our new rare, Kardashian. This set was really interesting because there are key cards for different cultures. Like if you wanted to play Romulan, you really needed the Continuing Committee. It was a good card. But the thing is, this set just overall wasn't that great unless you wanted to play Ferengi, because it was built around that. And if you didn't want to play Ferengi, you probably didn't need to buy this box or a box or any of these cards. You could trade for what you needed to. So this was a really underserved, underbought set at the time. So here's Brunt. If you're going to play Ferengi, he's a must in it. And a good card. And you can see the skills. You know, you've got the different types down here. Integrity, Cunning, Strength. You've also got the different skills they have to solve missions like FCA, Treachery, Navigation, Law, Greed, Computer Skill. You have their main clarification of VIP, their lore, and then just this tells you what the name of their, or what race they are. This tells you what set they are, this icon. This tells you that he can pilot smaller craft, but he can't pilot like bigger ships. He could be a helper on that. He would have the big gold star there if he piloted bigger ships. Of course, my terminology is going to be off. It's been since about 2000 since I've played Star Trek, played this game actually. It's really sad that I haven't played in that long. There's just no one around here that plays that I can get. Lamech, okay, so this is our second rare in this box. It's a double. So out of something like 8 packs, we pulled 2 of the same rare. I mean, as I said, terrible distribution. There's a non-aligned right here. So you can see him, Hogath, I believe, or Hagith, maybe it's Hagith. Their O's and A's in Decipher's text are very hard to tell what exactly they are. All right, the Neprim, I like this ship. So that is a Romulan, this is a Klingon ship that was commandeered by Dukat. And the Kardashians used it in the show, as well as a good card for the game. Let's see here, Quark's isolinear rods, an incident. If I remember right, this was pretty necessary if you wanted to play with the Ferengi at this time. Now, I was not someone, I bought a box of this, I opened it at the time when this came out, but I was not someone that played Ferengi. I never did. I loved Romulans. I loved playing them, and I also loved playing Bajoran. The person that I knew that got this set and basically broke it right out of the box was Brian Ribitaux. I mean, he took this set and just knew exactly what to do with it. So it was really interesting. So here's Senator Kratak. So are we making our money back? We might be able to break it. I mean, we've had some decent pulls. The Romulans do well. Now, the question is, are these cards near mint right out of the pack? And generally, they should be, right? But Decipher's cards had a really bad way of getting this top layer of, I don't even know how to describe it. It's just like this film on the top, and when you first look at it, it looks just cloudy, I guess is the best description. If you have something soft, you can rub it against it, and actually it will take that off, and it won't be a problem anymore. And it'll go back to being near mint, but if you leave it on there, if you touch it with your finger, it'll smudge it, and it'll have that smudge mark forever on that card. So that's never good. All right. So Arandis. Okay, so we are going to take and eventually get these rares onto our website. So they're all going to be listed as mint, near mint, because they're coming right out of the box. And we're also going to put the commons and uncommons on in mint, near mint. But the thing is, I just noticed on this last pack, not all of them came out this way. So let me take a look. So the last card, the top left corner of it here has a little bend. And I doubt that's from how I'm opening it. I'm not putting that much force into it. So I'm not really sure what that came from. I noticed that in at least 2 packs. So any ones like that, like this one's okay. Any ones like that, we will take out and we won't be including in the mint, near mint. They'll just be in the regular ungraded section. No Lita yet, no cork. I mean, those are our two that we really want to get. We've got a lot of other cards, though, that are pretty good. So, I mean, this has been a pretty good box so far as cards that we need just to restock and re-up our inventory. So, is it worth it in that aspect? Yes, yes it is. Did we reach the, say, let's say $10 mark? I don't know. I guess we'll see at the end. All right, we've got a Dominion Founder, one of the spies, that would be able to be in, would be playing for you. And I can't remember how that aspect worked when playing. It's been a long time, like I said. I haven't played since about 2000. This is about 16 years since I've read or looked at Star Trek rules. Ah, here's a good one. Rom. He's a key card from this set. So, I mean, he's one of the, obviously, the main Ferengi. He also had the Bajoran affiliation, so he could join in with Bajoran decks. And they didn't have a lot of, I believe, astrophysics. So it was nice to have a physics and astrophysics in a Bajoran deck. Alright, I believe this is the second Breakter. So out of this box so far, we've got three doubles, three sets of doubles. Which, as I said before, is pretty terrible. Let's see here. Alright, so here's our next rare, Bodyguard. The Bajoran had an interesting way. They would play Dabo. That was one of their tricks. I believe they could win points without ever having to really attempt missions. And I want to say that's how Brian Ribitto in Tennessee was able to break this set right out of the bat, right out of the box, and just really do some cool things with it. Oh, here's a good one. Cassidy Yates. Another Bajoran non-aligned affiliation. That's a good one. So from a player's standpoint, if you played Federation, this set really just didn't have a lot for you. In fact, you could basically skip it. If you played Romulan, you'd want to get it. There's about four or five Romulan rares that were pretty good. And then if you played Bajoran like I did, there's a few cards that you'd like to have from it. But again, this was a set that you could mostly trade for at the time and didn't need to actually go and buy it. Alright, oh, we pulled a cork. Here we go. I guess that would be your money card for the set, the key character. If we get a Lita now, we've got about 3-4 packs left. If we can get a Lita, that'd be great, because that would really finish off. We'd have Rom, Cork, and if we get Lita, right, that would be the big three as far as money probably goes from this set. Oh, we got a Morn. That's a good one, too. The character that was in every episode but never spoke. I played a Bajoran deck with Deep Space Nine, and I would, Morn was a character I'd always play in that. He fit really well in it. Phase cloaking device. Okay, two packs left. Let's see what we get. All right, Allura. Interesting. All right, we've got one pack left. What's it gonna be? We'll put some suspense in it. One, two, three. So there's our uncommons. Here's our commons. This is the last card. What is it? Ah, of course I throw it. Ah, it's a Lek. Okay, it's a little bit of a letdown. That's okay. So here we go. We've got all these cards here. Now, of course, the Cork is the best card so far. Rom is also up there. Now, did we make our money back? I mean, if you take 30 cards and you times a dollar, I mean, you've made $30 versus a 10 or so I sell it for. So if you're going to go off of just selling on eBay, it's probably worth it. If you're going on selling it on my website, it probably I probably make just a little bit if you include the commons, uncommons they'll put on, and mint, near mint condition too. Now, if you get some Decipher cards and you see that they've got, like this one has streaking on it, just take your finger, clear it off, and you'll see that that film comes off. As long as you haven't touched it with bare hands, that film will come off and it looks near mint like it should be. And that's how it is. But a lot of times people would get these Decipher cards straight from the pack. They wouldn't be wearing gloves. They touch it and your thumbprint would instantly go on it. It would then dry like that. and boom, your card is no longer near mint. This is Scott Church, category1games.com, bringing you a Rules of Acquisition box break. Again, thanks to Darium CCG for giving us an idea of breaking this down and seeing if this is worth it price-wise, as well as to Open Boosters. Both of them can be found on YouTube. Look them up. They both got some really cool stuff that they have going on. Thank you very much, and check out our website, category1games.com. We'll be back with more videos of breaking down boxes, new cards that we get in, and everything cool going on with classic card games, as well as adding retro video games soon.